Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about the continuity equation and what is the continuity equation derivation, right? So then what is continuity equation and what is its significance and what it will give? The continuity equation is a differential equation and it will give the variation of carrier concentration with respect to the time and distance. That is the continuity equation importance. Okay, so continuity equation is a differential equation and it will give the variation of carrier concentration with respect to time and distance. Okay, so now we are going to derive that continuity equation that gives the variation of carrier concentration with respect to time and distance. Okay, for that one, here I am taking an infinitesimal small semiconductor material, okay, of length dx, area of cross section A, and if length is the dx and area of cross section is A, then we can have the volume V is equal to A into dx, the length into area of cross section. So we will get the volume, right? So here we have, this is the semiconductor material what I have taken, infinitesimally small semiconductor of length dx here, length dx, and here the entering current at initial point is I, and at the end of this material, this infinitesimal small semiconductor material, so the current changes to I plus di. Okay, so here now we are going to use mainly three points. One is the increasing in the charge due to the generation of carriers, and another one is the decreasing in the charge due to the flow of current or from I to, or the current change from I to di. Okay, so another point is the decreasing in the charge due to the recombination of the holes and electrons. So these three points are very, very important. By using these three points and equations, we are going to derive the continuity equation. Okay, so now if I consider tau p is the mean lifetime of a carrier, okay, and another point is here, first I will derive the equation for the hole concentration, okay, and I will extend that that equation to electron concentration also. Okay, so for that case, here I am taking the tau p is the mean lifetime of a hole. Okay, so tau p is the mean lifetime of a hole, then p by tau p is the number of holes that will be lost due to the recombination. Okay, so here tau p is the mean lifetime of the holes, then I will consider here p by tau p is the number of holes lost due to the recombination. Whenever I already told that in the previous discussions that whenever a recombination is taking place, an old electron pair will be disappeared. Therefore, here if I consider that tau p is the mean lifetime of a carrier, then I will consider p by tau p is the number of holes lost due to the recombination. Okay. Therefore, the number of coulombs per second that is lost in the given volume is nothing but, here we will write it as the decreasing in the charge in the volume due to the recombination is. What is the volume here? Volume is equal to A into dx. But what we require is the charge decreased due to the recombination. So, due to the recombination, how many holes that will be lost is P by tau P, but we have to calculate for the total volume what is the decreasing in the charge. So that's why I am multiplying here the decreasing in charge is equal to the total number of holes lost, that is nothing but P by tau P, and it is multiplied with the volume. For the total volume means we have to consider. In this volume, what is the total number of holes that is lost due to recombination is P by tau P into A dx. But what we require, the total decreasing in the charge. So this much of holes are lost. That means how much charge that will be lost is equal to the number of holes for the volume that is lost multiplied with the charge of the hole, so that you can get the decreasing in the charge. So if you multiply this one with Q, that is the charge of the hole, then you will get the total decreasing in the charge due to the recombination. So that's what here I have indicated. I have written here as, so this represent ADX represent volume, and for that volume how many number of holes that will be lost is P by tau P multiplied with ADX, but we require how much charge that will be decreased. That's why I am multiplying the total holes number lost multiplied with the Q. Okay, so this is what the decreasing in the charge in the volume due to the recombination. Okay, so this is one point we have to consider while deriving the continuity equation, the first point. And next we will go with the second point. So here I will consider G is the thermal hole electron pair generation. Okay, if G is the thermal hole electron pair generation, why it is called as thermal hole electron pair generation means, here due to applying of external heat or light energy, there will be a hole electron pair will be generated. Okay, so that generation concentration we will consider as here, or the generation rate we will consider. Here G is the generation rate or thermal generation rate of hole electron pair. Okay, so if the hole electron pair will be generated, means automatically the carrier concentration will be increases. So previously we considered the decreasing in the charge due to recombination within the volume ADX. Now we are going to consider what is the increasing in the carrier concentration or hole concentration within the volume due to the thermal generation. Okay, so that is equal to Q A dx, and what is the rate of thermal generation is Z. That's why I will consider here Q A dx. So this represents, A dx represents the total volume and G represents the rate of generation of hole electron pair. So this total gives what is the concentration of holes that will be generated, and if you multiply with the Q, that will give the increasing in the charge, hole charge or hole concentration due to the generation of hole electron pair. Okay, so this is the second point we have to consider while deriving this continuity equation. And the third one is, here we are taking that here we are considering that the entering current is I, because of this recombination and generations, there will be a change in the current. The change in the current that is obtained at the outside or the another end of the material is, that is here I is the entering current, and another end of that material we have I plus di. Okay, here I plus I is the previous current what that is entering, but di is the change in the current. Okay, change in the current due to the recombinations. Okay, so that current I have to consider, and if there is a change in the current due to recombination, means automatically the decreasing in the charge will take place. Okay, due to this current change, there will be a decreasing in the charge in the volume. That decreasing in the charge is, I will take it as di. Okay, so because of all these three effects, because of recombination, the decreasing in the charge will take place. Because of generation, the increasing in the charge will take place. And at the same time, due to the change in current from one end of the infinitesimal material to the another end, there will be a change in the charge. Okay, so the charges will consider as di. Okay, the decreasing in the charges will consider as di. Okay, so because of all these three effects, we can say that the carrier concentration, here the hole concentration in the material, will change with respect to the time. Okay, therefore the total change or the total hole concentration due to all these three effects, we will write it as, in the volume we can write it as Q into ADX dP by dt. Okay, So did you all the three effects, the whole concentration, it changes with the time. Okay. Then how it will change? The change for any variable change with respect to time means how you can write it is written as, suppose x is the variable, we can write it as dx by dt. Similarly here the whole concentration is changing with respect to the time because of all these three effects. That's why I am writing within the volume the increasing in the carrier concentration or whole concentration here is q a dx dp by dt. So this is nothing but the volume, and this represents the change in the whole concentration with respect to the time. So if you multiply this total with q, that will give the total charge that will change, or the resultant charge that will be present due to the holes. So that is what qa dx dp by dt. Okay. So what I told, because of all these three effects, we are getting a change. That's why I am using here law of conservation of charge. Okay. So here law of conservation of charge means the total effect or resultant effect is equal to the all the three effects. Okay. All the three processes that is taking place here, the decreasing and increasing processes. Okay. Therefore, from the law of conservation of charge, I am equating this total value or the total change is equal to the individual effects, sum of all the individual effects. Sum of all the individual effects means decreasing in the charge due to recombination, increasing in the charge due to generation, and at the same time decreasing in the charge due to the current flow from one end of the material to the another end. Okay. So that is what I can write here. So this total change is equal to qa dx dp by dt is equal to, so the charge lost or the decreasing in the charge is minus, we have here aq dx p by tau p. Why I am using here negative? Because the charge is decreasing due to the recombination. This negative sign will indicate the decreasing in the charge due to the recombination. But here plus charge we are using. Why it is plus charge means, plus means here due to the generation of generation, whole electron pair will be generated. So the charge will be increased if that process takes place. So that's why we are using plus sign here. And here also the current, due to the current flow or the change in the current, the charge will be decreased. Okay, due to the recombination process, some current will change. That current change, due to that current change, the charge lost is Bi. Okay, so this is the equation what we got after equating the all the effects with the resultant variation of holes with respect to the time within the volume. So here if you observe all the equations, these three equations and the final equation, we have considered within the volume itself, because the total material we have here consists of a volume of A into dx. So this is about, I will take it as equation number 1. Okay. So out of this equation, we don't know what is the G value. We don't know what is the G value, and we don't know what is the Di value. Okay. Here, we don't know the G value, that is the rate of generation of whole electron pairs, and at the same time we don't know the Di value, so we have to calculate these two values. To calculate this value, I will consider this one. Okay, so at equilibrium condition, in the previous discussion only we have seen that at equilibrium condition there is no change in the carrier concentration. Therefore, if you do not apply any external field, okay. So that statement I am considering here to find out the G value. So at equilibrium, no external field is applied. No light, no external field is applied. Then there is no change in the carrier concentration or hole concentration at equilibrium. Therefore, I will take P is equal to, that is hole concentration is equal to P naught. P naught indicates what? The hole concentration at equilibrium condition. Okay. And at the same time, we are not applying any external field of light energy. So, there is no change in the whole concentration. That's why I am writing here, it is dp by dt equal to 0. And if there is no change in the hole concentration or carrier concentration, there is no change in the current. Because whatever it may be, the change that will appear in the current is due to the change in the carrier concentration. Here, if you consider there is no external field is applying, means we can consider as there is no change in the carrier concentration or hole concentration with respect to time, and because of that dI is equal to 0. And it is operating at equilibrium condition, so we will consider as P is equal to P naught. Okay. So if I substitute all these three values in the equation number 1, so that you can find out the G value. Okay. That is generation rate or thermal generation rate of whole electron pair. Okay. So that is the point. So I am substituting now, this P is equal to P naught, dI is equal to 0, and dP by dt is equal to 0 in this equation 1. Okay, if I substitute in this one, we will get is what? QA dx dP by dt is 0, and minus QA dx P by tau P. In place of P, what we have to substitute? We have to substitute P naught, because here we got that one. Okay, next one is what? QA dx G as it is minus dI. dI is what? dI is also, there is no change in the current because there is no change in the hole concentration. Automatically the current change is 0. So that's why dI is also 0. If I substitute all these values in the equation number 1, so what I will get? QA dx into 0, because dP by dt equal to 0, and here we have minus QA dx into, in place of P, what we have? P naught. So I am substituting P naught by tau P plus QA dx minus G minus 0. Okay. Now this value will be 0 and this is 0. So we have only two terms here, minus A dx P naught by tau P plus AQ dx into G. Okay. So if I bring this term to this side, what happened here? It is AQ dx P naught by tau P. And here we have AQ dx into G. Okay. So what happened here? This AQ dx will be cancelled with AQ dx. And we got only G. Okay. What we got? G is equal to P naught by tau P. Okay. So this G naught we will substitute again in the equation number 1. Okay. Then what you will get? QA dx dP by dt is equal to minus QA dx P by tau P plus QA dx into G is there. In place of G, what we have to substitute? We got is P naught by tau P. So I am substituting that one, minus dI. So therefore, the final equation is AQ dx dP by dt is equal to minus AQ dx P by tau P plus AQ dx P naught by tau P minus dI. Okay. Already we have calculated the G value. Now we are going to calculate the DI value. What is the DI value? Okay. Here we have to calculate the DI. Okay. For that one, we will consider what is the total hole current. Okay. I already explained about that in the previous discussions. In semiconductors, the total current is due to the holes and electrons, and holes diffusion and drift. So here we are dealing with the hole current. That's why I am considering here the total hole current. Okay. So if I is the total hole current, then I is equal to sum of diffusion and drift current of diffusion, drift current of holes. Okay, so we have discussed previously about the drift and diffusion current of holes and electrons. Okay, so here therefore to the sum of diffusion, drift current of holes. So what is the diffusion current of holes? Minus, it is drift current is nothing but minus AQ dP by dx. AQ DP DP by DX plus what is the drift current of holes. This is the diffusion current. What is the drift current of holes? That is nothing but A P mu P Q E. Okay. So here A is the area of cross section and P is the hole concentration and mu P is the mobility of holes and Q is nothing but charge of the holes is the electric field intensity applied. Okay. Now, but what we require here? We require DI. Okay. So, differentiate this equation with respect to the X so that we will get DI. Okay. So, here differentiate above equation or I with respect to the X. Okay, so what you'll get here if you differentiate this, so here A is constant, Q is constant and DP is constant and here also A is constant, P is constant and mu P is constant and Q is constant. Okay, so therefore DI by DX is equal to minus AQ DP d square p by dx square. Okay, so differentiate with respect to x, so therefore di by dx is equal to minus aq dp d square p by dx square plus a mu p q d by dx of pe. Okay. So, this is the DI by DX. Right? Now, I will take this DX to this side. Okay? One second. So, if I consider DI to this side, so what I will get? DI is equal to minus AQ DX DP D square P by DX square plus AQ DX mu P D by DX of P. Okay. So what I am doing here, this dx I am taking to this side so that it will become minus aq dx dp d square p by dx square and aq dx mu p d by dx of p. Okay, so this equation, if we substitute in the equation number 2 here, what we have equation number 2, so that you will get the resultant equation. Okay, substitute DI value in equation 2. Substitute DI value in this equation number 2. So what you will get here, AQ DX DP by DT is equal to minus AQ DX P by tau P plus AQ DX P naught by tau P minus, what is DI value here? This one. Okay, so that is minus of minus, you will get plus AQ DX DP D square P by DX square and this is minus of minus plus and here minus of minus multiply with plus, so we will get minus, so that is minus AQ DX mu P D by DX of P. Okay, so now we have in all these terms we have the common term, that is here AQ DX is there and AQ DX is there, AQ DX, AQ DX and AQ DX. So, if you consider the common in all these terms, so what you will get here, AQ dx dp by dt. So that is equal to what you get here? AQ dx, it is minus p by tau p plus p naught by tau p, and here it is dp plus dp d square p by dx square minus what we have if I take AQ dx common, that is minus mu p d by dx of p. Okay, so here on both sides I am taking the common, that is AQ dx, so that we will get this one. So this AQ dx and AQ dx will cancel. Okay, so what we will get here now? Now I can write this one as the resultant equation dp by dt, that is equal to, here I will take this one as, here if I consider tau p is common for both, that is therefore it is common, that is tau p, so we will get here p naught minus p by tau p, and it is dp d square p by dx square minus mu p d by dx of p e. Okay, so dp by dt we got is nothing but the change in the whole concentration with respect to time. We got here is p naught minus p by tau p plus dp d square p by dx square minus mu p d by dx of p. Okay, so if we observe this equation, the carrier concentration or the whole concentration is varying with respect to the time, and at the same time here with respect to the distance. Okay, so I already told that the significance of continuity equation. So the continuity equation is a differential equation which gives the variation of hole concentration or electron concentration with respect to the time and distance. So by observing this equation we can say that the hole concentration here varies with the time and at the same time the distance. Okay, so here the hole concentration is varying with time and distance, with time and distance x, the time t and distance x. So we can write above equation in differential form. So here this equation is varying, this variation of whole concentration is with respect to distance and time, that means it is varying with two variables. So we can extend this one or we can replace this one with the differential form. Okay, so this is dp by dt, so we can replace this one with the differential form, so we can use rho. Okay, so I will write that equation in the differential form as like this. So that is dou p by dou t. Okay, when we will use this differential equation means whenever a variable, a parameter is varying with respect to the other two variables, then we can represent that one in differential form. Okay, that's why here I am representing this whole concentration in the differential form, that is equal to p naught minus p by tau p plus dp dou square p by dou x square, okay, and minus mu p dou by dou x of PE. So this is the continuity equation in terms of variation of whole concentration. Okay, what I told, the continuity equation is a differential equation. This will indicate the differential equation, and it indicates the variation of carrier concentration with respect to the time and distance. Okay, so this is what our continuity equation. Okay, you can also extend this one for the electron concentration also. So how you can write for the electron concentration? Electron concentration variation is, that is nothing but dou n by dou t, that is n naught minus n by tau n. Okay, next, plus dn dou square n by dou x square minus mu n dou by dou x of n e. Okay, so this is the continuity equation for variation of whole concentration, and this one is extended to electron concentration also. Okay, so this is about the continuity equation derivation. Okay, thank you.